lots of people dressed up, lots of who's the cream of television here tonight, the cream of television actors. So it's a great night. Everyone's here, and it's just all, I always find it just a good time for everyone to meet each other's spouses and kind of chat and hold hands and have a bit of a laugh and a giggle, really.
Talking about the best of television, we're so excited about the new Supergirl series that you're involved in. What do you think fans of the original comic and the character can expect from the new TV version?
I think they're going to see a very different take on Supergirl. I think they're going to see they're going to have a lot of surprises. There'll be a lot of surprises, so I'd say it's definitely one to watch.
Of course, Melissa, our young star, is a beautiful young actress, but what's she been like to work with? And you say it's a different kind of Supergirl. What do you mean by that?
Well, as I say, you'll have to watch and see, but she kicks some serious butt, man. This is no kind of patsy. She's seriously strong and got a great outfit, looks great. This is Supergirl, very much Supergirl for the noughties.
Of course, your character's one that comic fans, aficionados, will already be a little familiar with, but for those who aren't, can you tell us a little bit about where you fit into the series and just how much of you we're going to see?
Well, you'll see a lot of me pre my comic book carnation. I play a character called Hank Henshaw, who ends up becoming Cyborg Superman and battling Superman and all the other superheroes, which I kind of like because in the last two shows I've been blown up. And when I get to be Cyborg Superman, you can't kill me, so I'm indestructible. So I'm looking forward to that.
I think obviously, there's a wonderful stable of DC TV shows like Arrow and The Flash at the moment. Do you think your character's one that could easily cross over into those universes? Is that something that's already been discussed with you?
Oh, you'd have to wait and see. I'm very much hoping so because, like I say, my guy, he's a tough dude. So I can take on anybody. I'll look forward to that.
Of course, Marvel's been doing really well on the big screen, but it seems like DC's sort of taking over on television. Were you aware of that rivalry, and is that something that ever kind of came up on set?
Not really, no, but I'm slightly aware, somewhat aware of it, because obviously it's the comic book genre seems to be very popular right now on American television and in movies. As you say, Age of Ultron being, a huge opening weekend last weekend, and on television you've got Gotham doing extremely well, Flash doing very well. So, they seem to be the new stories, so... It's a very exciting time.
When you mentioned Ultron there, I think the one criticism that's made of the superhero genre is that it's a little bit male-centric. Do you think that's why it's especially important to have a character like Supergirl, a strong female hero, finally brought to life?
I think people will be pleasantly surprised when they see Supergirl, and I think women will find it very heartwarming, and it's very much a female empowerment story, and there'll be a lot there for girls of all ages to really cheer about.
Of course, you've been playing a spy quite a lot lately. We've got Spooks the Great Good and Night Manager as well. Can you tell us a little bit about that project? I think with Tom Hiddleston and that.
Tom Hiddleston, Olivia Colman, Hugh Laurie, great projects. Great cast, good people, and there's just a lot of laughter on stage. So I'm enjoying that side of things.
Have you got a message for fans? I guess particularly comic book fans before you leave.
Make sure you tune into Supergirl. It's going to be great.